Good day. Welcome back. My name is Eric Gardien. I'm from Holland and I'm going to talk to you about recording a rock album because we are recording a rock album. But we are amateurs and you might think, whoa, how do you do that? And I'm going to explain it to you. This is the second video. In the first video, I gave you a general overview of what it's all about, in the sense that what are these videos are all about. And these videos are about having ideas about songs, believing in them and getting them to a place where you can release them, publicize them. That's what it is. So what you need to do is you need to have songs, people who play instruments and who can sing. You need to have recording equipment. You need to have a thing to record it in, a DAW. And you need to have platforms where you release your songs. Now we are going to start with recording. And recording in this day and age, I think you know about this because you are watching videos about recording and mixing and stuff like that. Otherwise you wouldn't be ending up here on my videos. Recording is very much possible in the home environment. And when I say home environment, I don't necessarily only mean home environment, but maybe in the rehearsal space where you and your band make a lot of noise every Saturday, whenever. Because you can record yourself. Now what do you need? You need a DAW, a digital audio workstation. This is very important. You need somewhere to record it into, but you know this. I think people watch these videos, they know about this. I use GarageBand from Apple. If you have an Apple computer, GarageBand is a free app. It's on there and it's a recording DAW. Of course you have Pro Tools and Logic X and Cubase and whatever, and these are all high level recording DAWs. But if you are not maybe a millionaire, or if you don't want to spend a lot of money on those things, then GarageBand can definitely help you out. It has basic functionality that leads you to recording.